$15 a month.
Only $6.99.
$15,000 in cash, and I'll take the 10th caller right.
Up your hands, grab that funk. Up your. Grab that funk. Up your. Wild boy. Out.
All the songs ever sung by Elvis are.
For the Farrah Fawcett Feel Alike contest. We'll take another look at the time and a whole new and exciting weather forecast coming up.
Bogus Productions presents the largest rock festival in concert history. Over 700 national rock groups will perform on a 22-acre revolving outdoor stage for 18 days and nights. Plus, you'll witness the cancellation of these incredible groups. Led Zeppelin, The Who, Peter Frampton, The Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, and more. Arrangements are being made for a triple LP, a movie, t-shirts, bumper stickers, posters, and matchbook covers, so don't miss it. The biggest, best rock festival in concert history. Advance tickets are only $85, $110 at the gate, cash only, no refunds. Notice, this is the last time a rock festival of this size will ever be held. To prevent a possible festival injunction, the concert site will be announced 6 hours before showtime. So be listening and get your tickets now. Attendance is limited to the first 3 million ticket holders. A Bogus Production.
Hi, I'm Ron Pentecost, welcoming you to the wonderful, wacky world of radio announcing. You know, friends say to me, Ron, how can I tell if I'm that lucky candidate who qualifies for that fast-paced, high-paying, everybody-likes-me kind of life you call the wonderful, wacky world of radio announcing? And I say to them, dear friends, what I'll say to you right now. Today's announcers have natural voices, typical of most of us, but you know you're not born with that special ability. Oh, no. The ability to breathe life into words, to give meaning to your sponsor's message. Here's an urgent message. So you don't forget, order before midnight tomorrow. A sincere message. Offer void where prohibited by law. An authoritative message. Substantial interest penalty for early withdrawal. A comedic message. Back to you, Peter Marshall. I repeat, you're not born with these abilities, but you can buy them right now at the Ron Pentecost School of Radio Announcing. And there are new classes forming soon for our Reverb Workshop. Interested in this kind of life? Of course you are. So write today for a free brochure to the Ron Pentecost School of Radio Announcing, Post Office Box 17, Pacoima. Not affiliated with Columbia School of Broadcasting, Columbia Broadcasting System, or anybody else.
This is your Real Rock, All Music, number one bumper sticker, progressive album, t-shirt, concert, radio station.
Turn it up. Don't turn it down. Cause I get my thrills when I hear that rock and roll sound. I'm a man, I'm a boy.
As long as we rock and roll.
I'm a man.
He's a man.
everywhere. The most devastating horror movie of our time. So realistic it's shocking. So shocking it's unreal. It's horrible. SGM Pictures presents No Parking.
George, I can't seem to find a parking place anywhere. I don't think there are any left.
No Parking. General panic and chaos cripples a nation on the day all the parking spaces were filled in the most chilling thriller ever to hit the screen. No Parking.
Starts Wednesday at the Plaza One Mini Cine with plenty of free parking.
Okay, let's take a quick look at the weather. Partly cloudy, temperatures less than 10% today, tonight, and tomorrow, with little change less than 20% out of the west to 10 miles per hour, with gust up to 8 in areas of intensity. The forecast for the metropolitan and surrounding two-state humidities under mostly skies, I have 8:15 a.m. That's 6:35 Celsius.
My name is Rudy DuBaker. I'm a student at the Midwestern University majoring in Granology. Recently, I enrolled in the White Cross Speed Reading course to improve my study habits. In just 2 short months of speeding, reading, I've learned to read 3,000 words per minute. In the next 30 days, I hope to comprehend these words. If you want to learn to read 3,000 words a minute with White Cross, attend the free mini course, and you'll be convinced. There, how's that?
Join us every third Tuesday of the month at 2 a.m. for the Token Jazz Hour. That's every third Tuesday at 2 a.m., the Token Jazz Hour.
Okay, so here as I said he would be, we now have in our studio Steve McNabb, lead singer for Garbage, and Steve has brought with him the brand new Garbage LP. Beautiful cover.
Thanks, Ryan.
Not yet, Steve. Beautiful cover. It's the name of your new album.
Yeah, that's right.
Beautiful cover by Garbage. Anything you want to say about the new album, Steve?
No, I just want to thank you guys for playing it.
Well, Steve, you know we play a lot of Garbage on this station.
Yeah,
and we hope you do very well with this new LP. Now, didn't you used to be with the Masochists before joining Garbage?
I don't understand the question.
Let me rephrase it. Didn't you used to be with the Masochists before joining Garbage?
Oh, no, I was in juvenile detention before joining Garbage.
Mm-hmm. And you had a record while in juvenile detention.
Yeah, but they promised to destroy all my records when I turned 16, you know?
And I understand now the group has taken on a new direction with this LP.
That's correct. Mm-hmm. The music is still punk rock.
Oh, no way, that's new wave music. We don't call it punk rock, new wave.
Oh, sure, whatever.
Okay. New wave.
Make it easy on yourself.
Uh-huh.
But we've added strings and a little touch of funky country, you know what I mean?
Steve, now, if you had to put your sound in a category, I understand musicians don't like to put their music in a category, categorize your music, but if you had to call it something,
break,
you know, jazz or rock or blues, or, if you had to do that, what would you call it?
Symphonic punk country disco, I guess.
And now that the album is finished, any plans for a tour in the near future? With the
yes, we will be going on tour.
Well, tell us about your new stage show coming up then.
Well, we just bought 3 tons of lights from Disneyland.
Oh, mm-hmm.
And along with these on our upcoming tour, we'll also utilize a small nuclear reactor, a smoke machine, a couple flare guns, some nude dancers on stage, things like that, and a fire alarm sprinkler system.
Now, Steve, what do you think about this strong trend we're seeing to add all these staging effects to rock concerts? Now, I understand the group you toured with last year did its entire show behind a huge X-ray screen.
Oh,
probably
really
had
great.
An incredible effect on your group.
It was incredible.
And more groups every day are electrocuting small animals on stage.
Uh-huh.
What do you think about this new trend to do that?
Oh, I think it's terrific.
Why is that?
Well, after the show, you always have something good to eat, you know?
No, seriously. Wait, this is on the air. People are listening.
They are? Well, okay. Actually, as more of our concert audiences become deaf from going to concerts...
Oh, wait. I don't think I really caught everything you said at the beginning of that sentence. Could you repeat it?
Sure. As more of our audiences become deaf from going to concerts, the more they need something to see when they go to the concert, you know.
Now, in addition to these special effects, I see in the back of the album here, you've added a few new members to the group.
That's true. You're absolutely right.
Could you tell me who's in the group?
Yes.
So who's on lead?
No, who's on bass?
Who?
Yes.
Well, what's the drummer's name?
No, what's the lead guitar player's name?
I don't know.
He's the drummer.
Who's the drummer?
No, who's on bass?
Who?
Yes.
Who's on bass?
Right.
Who?
Right.
Who?
Who?
On bass.
Right.
The bass player.
Who?
The guy on bass.
Right.
Who?
The bass player.
Who?
You got it.
I do.
Let's just move to the horn section, okay?
Why don't we just look at some of the songs on the album instead? What do you think?
You can look at them all if you want.
Good. Let's start with song one, cut one. It's entitled Lovely Lady. That's very original.
Yeah, I bet you never heard a song like this one before.
No, I haven't. What's it about?
Well, it's about being on the road,
you know? That's a good idea.
We thought it would be original to write a song about being on the road, because as a rock group, we're always on the road, you know what I mean?
I see. Well,
what about roadies and groupies and shit like that.
Well, this song here called Bend Over Beethoven, who wrote that?
Yes, and he did a hell of a good job, too.
Who?
Right.
Who wrote it?
Yes.
Who?
Yes.
He's on bass, right?
Who?
Who? The bass player?
Right.
Why don't we just listen to the song, Bend Over Beethoven, by Garbage, from the new album Beautiful Cover, and...
I wanted to tell you that this is the only song on the album that has the original members of the group, including Scott Lowe, on explosives.
That's interesting.
Yes, that's because this song was recorded way, way back when the group first got together.
And how long ago was that?
3 months ago.
Oh, okay. This is from the new Garbage LP entitled Beautiful...
Simply entitled.
Right. Beautiful Cover, and this is called Bend Over Beethoven. Okay, that was brand new from Garbage, Bend Over Beethoven. And before that, we heard from Steve McNabb from Garbage. And before that, well, we heard some commercials. In just a few minutes, we'll be giving away some free passes to see that new disaster movie, Elevator 1980, right after this, so stay with us.
Jesse Jeff Westchester has saddle sores, and he sings all about them on his hot new LP, simply entitled Saddle Sores.
My bottom hurts, but I'm riding on, 'cause I feel all right on the whole. Yeah, them saddle sores.
Saddle Sores by Jesse Jeff Westchester. Another great effort to pass off country western as progressive music, where you'll hear songs of love.
I love her like a horse, but I can't find a saddle for her size. I mean a female horse, of course, but she's just a pony in disguise.
Plus, 10 more great songs
in this album, 10 more great songs I do sing.
And another song.
Here's another song for you.
And one that sounds like country blues.
And here is one that sounds like country blues.
Jesse Jeff Westchester, Saddle Sword. Living testimonial that country music sure is easy to sing.
Yeah, them saddle sores. Oh, them saddle.
Available now at your favorite record store and my stores you don't like to.
Bottom hurts 'cause those saddle sores.
We're going to magnify this pimple 100 times to show you how new Derma Drug Skin Putty fight acne pimples the natural way. Derma Drug Skin Putty doesn't cover up or dry up unsightly, ugly, juicy pimples like ordinary treatments. It bites down hard like two sharp fingernails and squeezes till the nasty zit explodes from your face. It's the natural way to attack pimples. Derma Drug Skin Putty, now available in 22 exciting colors.
Highwater Pants at $31.95, 28th Street is having its fourth semi-annual 20 to 25% off sale on all merchandise normally priced 10 to 15% off the normal everyday low, low price of crazy low discount prices. This Thursday, Friday, and Saturday from 10 to 10, Thursday and Friday and 10 to 5, Saturday, all Highwater Pants is in size 21 to 30 will be marked down from 20 to 25% off the regular 10 to 15% off the everyday low prices. You heard me right, 25% off the low prices. All regular $25.95 jeans normally broke down in $29.95, $16.95. All $35.95 jeans selling for $29.95 to $26.95 at Highwater Pants, $31.95, 28th Street. Open Monday and Wednesday from 10 to 7, 30, Tuesday and Thursday, Friday from 10 to 10, and Saturday from 10 to 5, holidays 10 to 7 to 3. And off in Tennessee, except in April. Plus, Highwater Pants downtown at 3119 West South Wing Street under the bridge. It opened 10 to 5 and 9 to 5. Then it's Monday, Friday, Saturday, and Friday. Where Highwater Pants, where shopping is made easy.
Okay, I now have two free passes to see that new disaster movie, Elevator 1980, a terrific movie about six people who are stuck in a possessed elevator during an earthquake and two are eaten by a shark. And I'll give away two free passes to the first person who can send in a postcard with the correct answer to this trivia question. Tell me the name of Roy Rogers Trigger. I'll take the fourth postcard.
Do it.
Do it again.
Oh, oh.